As Uganda will join the rest of the world to commemorate the International Labour Day tomorrow, CSOs say the plight of Ugandans employed by investors is wanting. They say although the government has worked towards enforcing and strengthening legislation to promote labour rights, much is left to be desired. They want issues such as poor and precarious working conditions and lack of adequate maternity protection, unfair dismissals, low wages, and inadequate occupational safety addressed.
The Investment Code Act 2019, despite recently being amended, still has many gaps. For example, it doesn't provide for a requirement for human rights impact assessment to be undertaken by investors prior and during implementation of investment projects. It also doesn't provide for performance requirement measures and due diligence. The Employment Act 2006 also doesn't protect workers against casualization of labor. In addition, the current provisions of the Employment Act 2006 do not protect workers currently working under the new forms of work, which are rampant on the labor market, for instance, temporary agency work, workers employed by both labor intermediaries, brokers, and user undertakings, outsourcing, telework, remote work, platform work, and many more. All these forms of work are precarious and exploitative outside a clear regulatory framework. Uganda has signed a number of bilateral investment treaties, of which six are in force. The treaties focus on protecting the rights of investors at the expense of citizens' rights. As such, investors have not been held accountable for the acts they have committed in violating people's rights and environmental rights. The lacuna in our investment-related policy frameworks has hit harder on women workers, especially those that have limited capacity and the ability to understand and negotiate for better terms.
These also say workers' situations is made even worse and untenable as a result of the existing unfair minimum wage of Uganda shilling 6,000, approximately $1.61. This rate has not been reviewed since 1984.
A country's wealth is not its what is on the ground. A country is its people. Your citizens are your wealth. So when you invest in your citizens, then you've invested in your country. If you look at the executive of this country, they employ quite a number of people who are redundant. Who are the redundant people I'm referring to? The number of special advisors. The number of, we have a big, big public admin that is so bloated. So I think if you invest in your people by putting in reforms that can make your workers be productive and motivated, you will be able to build the economy.
We need work which is will improve the dignity of a worker in the country. When you go to all these other countries, ILO and other organizations have come out strongly to commend the government to ensure that workers have decent work. And decent work is something that we all can be proud of. I'll just give a scenario. About 60 journalists are on the street. The CTV. They just sent people away in February last year, and they were not paying them up to today.
According to the International Labour Organization estimates, every year 2.34 million people die due to occupational fatalities, 2.02 million of which result from work-related diseases, equivalent to 5,500 deaths every day.